as a setter when I played, and I specialize in training setters. And so this is just learning how to set, but I will let you know in the sessions to come, there will be a special course that just focuses on the position of setting with the tempos and with the footwork and with the hand position and leadership and all those wonderful things. So if you are interested in being a setter, make sure that you look for that in the future. So step number one in setting is very similar to receiving a ball when you're passing. You want to face where the ball is coming from. So whether you are a setter or you're receiving the ball from another player and you're setting in for the setter, make sure that you are facing where the ball is coming from. You want to make sure that your hands are ready to set the ball. And so what we tell our players is you want your hands to be in the shape of the ball. The ball is going to be coming into your hands. A good tip may be to go ahead and put your hands on your waist just to know what that feeling is like with your wrist back. And when you take it, it's almost in this shape. You can also just grab a ball and put your hands all the way around it in the shape. And then when you drop it, your hands are in the shape of the ball. We don't want our hands to be flat, and we're not sticking our fingers out ready to set. A lot of people may think, oh yeah, the setter is the one that uses her fingers, right? No. The setter uses her hands. The more surface that you get on your hand, on the ball, is going to give you more control on where that ball is going. The third step to setting is squaring to target. And again, the ball knows angles, and when we're using our hands, we're actually manipulating and changing the direction of where the ball is coming from. And so as you go ahead and you accept the ball into your hands, you want to make sure that as you are setting, that you are squaring up to where you want the ball to go. Same thing as a basketball.